Let's talk about the boob quake.
Yeah, I'm in.
You don't even know what a boob quake is.
Does it involve boobs?
It does.
Well then, please continue.
On April 19th, 2010, a Muslim cleric in Iran blamed earthquakes on women who dressed immodestly.
Come on, is this real?
It is. Hojato Islam Kazem Siddiqui,
easy for you to say,
said that women who do not dress modestly lead young men astray, corrupt their chastity, and spread adultery in society, which increases earthquakes.
That doesn't sound scientific.
No, it doesn't, but there's a twist. Siddiqui was a senior cleric who responded to a prediction by President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad that Tehran will be struck by a devastating earthquake. He blamed women who were showing a little too much skin. And he said the only way to avoid being buried under the rubble is to take refuge in religion and to adapt our lives to Islam's moral codes. Now, Jen McCreight was a student at Purdue University when she heard this. And she didn't like the idea of natural disasters being blamed on sinful women. So she decided to do something about it. She wrote a blog post entitled, "In the Name of Science, I Offer My Boobs."
Young lady, we salute you.
Jen McCreight wanted to refute the cleric's supernatural claims. She said that on Monday, April 26th, she would wear the most cleavage-showing shirt she owns, and she encouraged other female skeptics to join her.
A call to boobs!
It was. She said all women should wear low-cut shirts, short shorts, or whatever their preferred type of modesty was. By the end of the week, over 100,000 women pledged their support. Hashtag boobquake was trending on Twitter, and quite predictably, the media ran with the story.
Exposing cleavage in the name of science?
I don't have cleavage, though. So, I think I'm going to, duct tape.
There's a name for this behavior.
Boobquake!
And, by Monday morning, over 200,000 women pledged their solidarity to the cause. It was time to test the cleric's theory. The boobquake was on. The boobquake epicenter,
a geology joke, nice,
was at the Purdue Bell Tower in West Lafayette, Indiana. But women were gathering all over the country. Immodest clothing choices included push-up bras, short skirts, and all kinds of racy outfits. There were signs like, "God hates boobs."
He definitely does not.
And the day's theme was cleavage for science.
I don't think this is what they meant when they said we need more women in STEM.
Probably not, but the event was still lighthearted and fun and intended to empower women. And Jen McCreight wrote mockingly that with the power of our scandalous bodies combined, we could surely produce an earthquake. And 200,000 women, that's
almost 400,000 boobs, if my math is correct.
Right. So women gathered everywhere, their boobs on display, and then...
What?
Taiwan was hit with an earthquake that was a 6.9 on the Richter scale.
Boobquake!
Boobquake founder Jen McCreight was quick to point out that over 100 times every year, Taiwan experiences earthquakes of that size, though she admitted that if more earthquakes followed, she might rethink her position on the supernatural power's breasts. The earthquake in Taiwan probably wasn't a boobquake, but there was some backlash. A professor at Rutgers and some feminists were critical of boobquake, which they believed further victimized and objectified women. They countered with their own event called Brainquake, which would happen on the same day.
Brainquake?
Yep. So boobquake supporters were encouraged to show off their boobs. Brainquake supporters were encouraged to show off their resumes.
Oh boy, I think boobquake had the stronger marketing campaign.
It did. And I think this is the problem with people who live and breathe politics and activism. Jen McCreight is a liberal feminist. Boobquake was not meant to encourage the objectification of women. She wanted to bring attention to a culture that treats women much worse than just ogling. Now that said, I'll admit the main reason the story was so popular was not because of feminism. But whether you support the cause or just
support boobies.
Right. Either way, the important point is that boobquake was about female empowerment and defiance. It was a way for women to proudly and openly say they will not be marginalized. Boobquake might have attracted a lot of attention from men, but it wasn't meant for them. Boobquake was for women. But even Jen McCreight admits the irony of boobquake. She said if the imam had blamed natural disasters on banana hammocks, today would be so different.
Amen to that.
Thanks so much for hanging out with me today. My name is AJ, that's Hecklefish. This has been The Y-Files. If you had fun or learned anything, do me a favor and like, subscribe, comment, and share. That stuff really helps. Until next time, be safe, be kind, and know that you are appreciated.
Boobquake, from Purdue to Pensacola, boobquake, we'll rock the Ayatollah, boobquake, how is it a sin, boobquake, show a little skin, boobquake, from Purdue to Pensacola.